Still doesn't show the FPS counter for you, does it? I'm done screwing with the game, I just want to play it. I was trying to fix the EMB I used for New Vegas today and couldn't figure it out. I'm gonna try to get that fixed tomorrow. Really don't know why they just suddenly decided to stop working, but whatever. Whatever. I was trying to troubleshoot some stuff on this earlier today too. I actually spent more time troubleshooting this than New Vegas, but I really didn't get a whole lot accomplished for either. I don't think my face is washed out when there's no direct light on it. When there's light, it tends to wash out. I guess that's kind of realistic though. I was wondering about something. Where is... Here's the thing. Or, God, I can't even remember what it's called. Project Reality. Good Lord. Assuming all these are enabled already, right? Seems like. Almost seems like it saved all these settings from the last time I played. Kinda like that. Get up. Oh, I forgot there was gas over here. Just blew myself up. This is where I started. What? Why can't I read this? Pretty sure I missed something. think I need to turn down light.
Again, sweet America, this is President John Henry Eden, and I'd like to chat if you've got a moment. Did you know there are those amongst us who would shatter our hopes for peace, order, and security? These radical malcontents don't care about you. They don't care about America. All they care about is fulfilling their own selfish desires. Let's take a tally of these agitators, shall we? There are, of course, the raiders, those anarchistic ruffians who roam the wastes, preying on any and all, stealing, murdering. The so-called Brotherhood of Steel. Don't be fooled by their pseudo-knightly nonsense or supposed connections to the United States Army. These power-armored Boy Scouts are nothing more than common criminals with access to some antiquated technology. Criminals who have had the audacity to claim this country's most important military installation, the Pentagon, as their own personal clubhouse. And don't be fooled, America. Those who have left the Brotherhood of Steel, branded outcasts, are just as dangerous, even more so, being in exile. And what about the slavers of Paradise Falls? The frighteningly irradiated ghouls of Underworld? And last but not least, the hideously mutated super mutants that have completely overrun the entire downtown DC area. Lawlessness, terror, murder. They're all around us, I know. I know. But not for long, sweet America. Not for long. Oh. Enclave will restore peace, order, and prosperity to this great nation. And those who oppose us will be removed forever. So remember, America, the Enclave is working around the clock to return this country to greatness. All you need is a little patience, a little faith. Till we meet again, this is John Henry Eden signing off.
I don't even remember what I was doing.
I'm President John Henry Eden, and you're listening to Enclave Radio, the voice of warmth and reason in this cold, unreasonable world. Greetings, dearest America. This is your president, John Henry Eden. Let's chat.
Sorry, I tried to get most of this done before.
Discuss something rather important.
Tried to stream.
Well, my presidency. The question has been raised, I know, as to just how I came to be elected to this most illustrious office. Or whether or not I had been elected at all. To that, I must answer, of course. Of course, I was elected.
Alright.
Of course. Isn't the right to vote the very foundation of a democracy? Fortunately, in the interest of national security, I'm not at liberty to discuss the details of the election. You understand? But rest assured, I am your president, because the appropriate people of this great nation decided I should be. I am your duly elected representative. Of course, when the time comes, when my term is up, America will be free to elect a new president. And that person will...
And just make sure those activated. Sometimes this crashes the game. Oh, it didn't. Good.
Well, that takes time. Even for the Enclave. Till next time, this is your president, John Henry Eden, signing off.
There's supposed to be some briefcase. Load them up. I remember if it was this or New Vegas. Pretty sure I had energy weapons enhanced for both. Or Eve, at least, for both. I don't remember if EWE is for both, too. Energy visuals enhanced or something. But anyways, I remember in one or the other, there were some death animations where it would just float up into the air and then explode. I'm excited to see that happen. Oh shit.
Will you startle
me? Holy shit, that scared me.
You really mustn't creep up on people like that.
Up on you, yeah, I really did just crap my pants.
That's no way to talk to a man of science. I don't have time for this kind of childish nonsense. I have some very delicate experiments that I must attend to. I've chosen this room as a temporary retreat from which to contemplate my erroneous figures for my experiments. It may be a bit dark and damp, but such annoyances will not stand in the way of science. My experiments are of a complex nature and would take a scientist to explain. Oh, wait, I'm a scientist. How marvelous. My foray into reducing the girth of these insectoid creatures is of utmost importance. I intend to generationally reduce their immense stature by way of a pre-birth induced mutagen. Isn't that clever? My word, you understand perfectly. How marvelous! Well, this is rather embarrassing, so you'll have to forgive me, but it appears that I've made a slight miscalculation in my mutagen samples. Instead of lowering the size of the ants, the brood hatched and developed a new biomechanism. I call their genetic aberration pyrosis, the ability to emit flame from their bodies. I may be able to correct this error, but I can't get near my equipment. Your knowledge of experimental procedure surprises me. Indeed, I have skipped a step and directly modified an entire brood. Perhaps I was too hasty. I was so certain it would work. To correct this mistake, I'll need to get to my terminal to modify the mutagen. Since you've offered, allow me to elaborate. My portable terminal is set up in the hatchery chamber near the ant queen. If I can reach it, I can continue to work on improving the mutagen. If she were harmed in any way, months of data would be lost. Your objective would be to eliminate what I call her quintet of nest guardians. Filthy little abominations. I've rigged the equipment at my portable terminal to emit what I call an inhibitor pulse. Once I send this pulse, all of the remaining ants will lose their empathic link with the queen and frenzy, destroying each other in the process. So, that's all there is to it. What do you say?
Yeah, whatever.
You will? How marvelous! Be careful, my friend. The nest guardians can be quite tenacious. Be ever vigilant. Those from the genus Solenopsis are not to be trifled with. I suppose I could answer a few more queries.
Got a little toy car in your bed. Huh. He's just letting me help myself to this stuff. Go with 10 minutes just to make it a little more punishing.
That's right, America. Before we were devastated by atomic war, each state had its own professional baseball team. Imagine the perfect cloudless day. The sun is warm, welcoming. And on the horizon, they appear like knights of yore, armed with bats of ash and hickory. Their name, the Capitol Congressman. Their purpose, to make you, dear America, revel in the joys of sport and sunshine, if only for an afternoon. Now, ask yourself this. What if the Capitol Congressman could live again? What if they could compete with baseball teams from Pennsylvania or Maryland? Put your faith in John Henry Eden, great America, and baseball will live again. Comfort, recreation, healthy competition, all will live again. This country will live again. But for now, my America, we must part. Restoring the greatest country in the world to its former glory, well, that takes time. Even for the Enclave. Until we meet again, this is President Eden signing off.
Why don't the quick save buttons work? Just try. That doesn't work. Whatever, I don't even care. Wait. Oh, that was a coincidence. And press the button right at the same time as the autosave. Better music than this.
Okay.
what's going on. Audio seems like it's tripping out in me. Oh shit. Ant vision. Probably should have read that before I took it. Ah, crap. I don't want to have to come back in here. Wait. Oh, I see why. I couldn't do it because I'm dumb from the thing. Want to know what's in that box. Hold on. Stupid pop-up. How long is this gonna last?
I've detected some changes within the Queen's hatchery with my equipment. What's transpired? Far too curious. His incessant questioning would often come when I was the most absorbed with my calculations. He had no regard for the importance of my work. You have your ideals and I have mine. I'm down here to complete my experiments at any cost. If that means the loss of a few lives to save generations of lives in the future, it's a small price to pay. All scientists take responsibility for their failures because it comes with the territory. I will take this experimentation to completion without roosting on the moral high ground. If I allow emotions to enter the mix, all this time and energy spent will have been for nothing. I can't risk leaving this place. I have to continue monitoring the hatchery for any further mutations in the next brood. I have no time for children and their petty games. What do they know about the importance of my work?
Yes?
Well, the mutagen has enhanced their fortitude and provided them with what I call pyrosis, the ability to emit flame biologically. They're quite radiation-free, however. Well, as radiation-free as any other mutated creature in the wasteland. Playing with genetic codes isn't simple. Do you realize one tiny tweak at any point in the last million years could have completely changed us? Going from attempting to change their size to generating their pyrosis ability is no surprise at all.
Yes?
Oh my, yes, they're quite marvelous. There are many that say it can't be done, but I'll prove them wrong. Destroy? Oh, no, no, no! You mustn't do that. It's my life's work. Just clear me a path to my equipment and I'll do the rest when you tell me it's safe. By introducing my mutagen directly into an ant egg, I hope to reduce the size of the adults. This is a generational system, meaning it will take quite a few broods before the ants are at their destination size. In the end, I hope to make them as small as they were over 200 years ago.
Yes?
Oh, how marvelous! Please, tell me what happened. Then I will proceed to my portable terminal at once and make the necessary changes to the formula. Thanks very much for everything. You've been quite a useful lab assistant. How marvelous! Which injection did you want? Will it be the ant site or ant mite?
Hmm. Option's pretty important, but never hurts to have more strength.
Very well. Return to me when you're ready. Much to do.
Wait up. Oh, crap.
Yes, what did you need? Be ever? Yes, what did you need? How marvelous! Which injection did you want? Will it be the ant sight or ant mite?
I think I'm gonna have to go with the strength.
How marvelous! Ant mite it is! Hold still, please.
Perception will be good too, though. And I really don't know. I don't even know if that's that big of a deal.
Yes, what did you need? How marvelous! Ant sight it is! Hold still, please.
Alright.
Yes,
whatever.
What did you mean? You should take him away from this place. Find him a home. It would be difficult to accomplish my experiments with him scampering about and asking an interminable amount of questions. Yes? Well, I will continue my research. There has to be a... Until then, I will be staying in my shack next to the Wilkes' home should you ever wish to visit me. Much to do, so much to do.
I want to see what happens to this guy. Guess it doesn't really attack him. is this gonna wear off? Why won't this ant vision go away? Oh, whoa. What is going on? There, finally. Jeez. Never gonna make that mistake again. Make some room. think that may need to go down a little more. The light intensity. I have very little idea what I'm doing right now. That's a lot better, actually. Christ. Oh, that may occur. Oh, no, it didn't. All right, two, be better now. That looks a lot better, actually. What is this? What do you mean, authorization error? Or am I supposed to be using this key? Is that safe I couldn't open earlier? I have no idea where it was. Ah, crap. Or was that safe? Was it over here? I think it was. Here we go. That all that was in it was naughty nightmare? Did I blow up the rest of it?
I'm only gonna ask you this one time. Give me the naughty nightwear. I warned you I was only going to ask once. Now I'm going to take it from you.
Shouldn't have done that. Didn't I have a silenced 10mm in here? Need that. Not very good.
I'm only going to ask you this. Wrong answer. Yeah, that's what. Bye. Look what we have here.
Really? Great, whatever. I had a different weapon that time. Oh, that's loud. You know what? I'm gonna do that again.
I'm only gonna ask you this one time.
Different gun again.
Give me the naughty nightwear.
And a mask.
Wrong answer, dead meat. That was probably the dumbest thing you could have said. Fine, have it your way.
Hmm. especially good shotgun. We'll see. Uh-oh. You're a big guy, Woody. Uh-oh. I think I shot the wrong person. Oh god. Definitely did. Aw man. All the way back here. Alright, I'm gonna have to change. Frequency. Leave the guns and take the cigarettes. I'm so lost.
I'm watching you. I'm only gonna ask you this one time. Wrong answer. Yeah. Bye.
Looks a little goofy. Oh my. Has science gone too far?
Thank you.
crap.
Nothing to see here, outsider.
Stranger, I thank you for your aid. We must press forward. If you are willing to aid us, you are welcome to join us.
Wow. That second response.
We were performing a training exercise with one of the initiates when we were cut off by the super mutants. We saw him flee into a building up ahead during the attack, but before we could link up with him, we were pushed back. Now that we've cleared this area, we can press forward and attempt to recover the initiate. I only pray that he is unharmed. Unfortunate, but understandable.
Targets acquired. Where?
Oh no, now I can't do it? Shit. I realize I had to do it then or never.
Yes? Contact. Opening fire. Engaging target. Look out.
Hey, really? What's going on here? Great. Do all that shit again. I really need to make some inventory space. I gotta do that first before I go back over there. Make some space real quick. Maybe talk to this kid on the way. check something else. And try the bloom again. I turn it down. Oops. Can see that frame rate counter. A little bit big though. Yeah, screw it.
Specifically, your government, dear America, the Enclave. Just who is the Enclave? Why, now that's simple. The Enclave is you, America. The Enclave is your sister, your aunt, your friend, your neighbor. And well, yes, the Enclave is me as well. As your president, it is my responsibility to preside over our great. So, as your president, I am the voice, I am the heart and soul of the Enclave. That is to say, I am the voice, heart and soul of America. But only together, together, can we hope to reach our full potential, the way we were before the war, whole. Country in the world to its former glory. Well, that takes time, even for the Enclave. Till we meet again, this is President Eden signing off.
All right.
is hot in here. It was so weird. All of a sudden, the ants went nuts and started fighting each other. It was like they were totally crazy. It was really scary, but kind of cool at the same time. You know what I mean? I wish I had something to give you for all the work you did. But I never really had much to start with. I guess now you'll be on your way, and I'll have to try living here by myself. I hope you'll come back and visit someday. Really? You mean it? Oh boy, thank you so much. I'll wait in my old house for you to come back. I need to bury my papa anyway. Just don't forget about me. No. What happened? Yeah. I snuck back home a little while ago and found him lying there. I guess I already knew anyway. I just needed to see for myself. Besides, I'm too tired to cry anymore. You're pretty swell for a grown-up.
I like to think I'm pretty swell. Correct. What's that sound? Ooh. is that? Wait, can I even still catch up to these guys?
Hello.
Oh God. Ah, just kill me now. Where's the head guy? Shit. Shit. Why am I way out here?
see you. Hello.
Stranger, I thank you for your aid. We must press forward. If you are willing to aid us, you are welcome to join us. We were performing a training exercise with one of the initiates when we were cut off by the super mutants. We saw him flee into a building up ahead during the attack, but before we could link up with him, we were pushed back. Now that we've cleared this area, we can press forward and attempt to recover the initiate. I only pray that he is unharmed. Excellent. We will advance forward slowly until we make contact with the mutants, then clear the area in front of the building. Once that space is under our control, we will hold position while you enter and recover the initiate. Then, you both should evac to the exterior.
Scroll with this one, or zoom, I mean, variable zoom. This one I can, though. And they need a medical brace. Not really sure where the whole thing was supposed to be going down. Confused where they went. It'd be nice to have a brace right about now.
Yeah? I have a few things.
The hell is wrong with her lips? I don't think this is where they went.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. kick ass!
name is Werner. I come...
By order of the Federal Communications Commission, all standard radio and television stations in the United States are off the air in the first daytime test of the Connell-Rad system of emergency broadcasting. This drill is being conducted in conjunction with Operation Alert, the nation's exercise.
Holy crap.
Receive civil defense information in the event of a national emergency. Remember to keep your battery radio and your standard radio in good condition so that in case of enemy attack, you can get vital civil defense information and instructions.
Oh my God. Holy shit. I don't understand. Why are there so many? Holy shit. Why are there so many of them? I just don't understand. Time.
Where?
Holy crap. Yeah, I may have to wait on this one. I really don't understand. FPS is tanking here.
I'm Doc Church, and I run this clinic. Now, before you go asking me for help, you'd better know the rules. Rule one, don't bother me. If you do bother me, you better be damn near dead. I'm busy enough taking care of people I actually like. Follow my rule, I'll keep you patched up, I'll keep getting paid, and we'll get along just fine. All right. You're not... Then... All right. You don't got nearly enough holes in you to be bothering me.
Gather and behold the power of Adam. Let those who dwell here in his favored land attend now to the words of the prophet of Adam.
Well, hot damn! Someone new. All name's Billy Creel. You call me Billy, all right? I know Megaton looks more like a boneyard than a town, but it ain't all bad. Take me and Maggie, for instance. We make do just fine. I trade the stuff I scavenge, and she helps keep me on the straight and narrow. Oh, sorry. I guess I got ahead of myself, huh? Maggie's 9. Sweetest little girl you'd ever care to meet. We take care of each other. I ain't never had a daughter, but if I did, I'd want her to be Maggie. I took her in when her parents got killed by raiders. That was 2 years ago. It was a pretty bad scene. Small settlement up north. I'd stopped in to trade some salvage, and the whole place had been wiped out. I found Maggie hiding under a bed in the same room where her parents had been butchered. We've been together ever since. People have been saying that there's something wrong with the water purifier, but old Walter's been keeping that thing running for decades. I'm not worried. No reason it'd pick now to go down for good, would it? Catch you later.
Billy, I want to talk to you.
Anything for you, honey?
You said we could have that talk sometime. You know, about boys. I'm ready. I'm ready now. There's some stuff I need to know. Like, really bad.
Oh, well. Well, now. You know, Maggie, sweetheart, that boys and girls, Aw, hell, girl, can't you talk to Moira about this stuff?
All right, Billy. But you can't avoid the subject forever, you know.
I know, sweetheart. Now you run along, okay? Billy's got some thinking to do.
A little weird.
What do you...
So, how's the scavenging been? Got the food and medicine? Oh, well, could you get on that? Sure thing. Good hunting.
What are you doing? I don't think I have anything you'd want.
Nobody noticed me. See me.
How's the field research going? How's the field research going?
Man. area.
Yeah, please go away. Hi, I'm Maggie. I live with Billy Creel. Do you know him? He's not my dad or anything.
I got my eye on you. I got nothing to say to you.
You're looking for the mayor or the sheriff?
You these feeble bones. I present to your will this frail body. I beg of you to use me as your vessel.
You need something?
Guide me to your prison.
Yeah, you need something? You looking to trade, stranger? Check out Craterside Supply.
Who have we here? Could it be a new addition to our humble little community? Dear child, welcome. Welcome to Megaton. I am Confessor Cromwell, prophet of Atom and father of the Undying Glow. Please, child, come to the church anytime, anytime at all. Rays shower you, child.
You looking for the mayor or the sheriff?
Thank you.
one gives me one strength, but... there's a lot more damage with this.
This is Enclave Radio with your host, me, President John Henry Eaton. And now, one of my inspirational quotes from the mouth of your president, John Henry Eaton, straight to your heart. It's easier to do a job right than to explain one.
Can't see anything. Oh no. Oh, really? What the fuck's going on? Game just crashed. I think so. Wow, it's really late. I did not realize how late it was. Understand what this is. But alright, hope you enjoyed watching. Hope you join me next time. We'll do the Super Duper Mart. Some of the whatever it's called. The Wasteland Survival Guide mission line, quest line. Anyways, hope you join me then. Hope you enjoyed for now. Catch you then. Catch you next time. Hope you enjoyed. Catch you later. Peace.